Hi, I'm Danielle, and I have my model here, Devin, with me today. We're going to do a contour and highlight, and then finish with an eye look. All right, let's get started. I'm going to use the contour kit in the light to medium, since Devin is, of course, light skin tone. I'm going to start with a little bit of Havana on a Morphe 527 brush. And the reason why is because it's really fluffy, it's not very dense, and I want to use it just to warm up her complexion first. We're going to go where the sun would naturally hit. And the reason why we're doing this before we contour is so that way we can have a real smooth blend with our contour and it won't look harsh. Everything will look really well blended and natural. Always start with a little and work it in. So once the complexion is warm, we're going to take the Sephora Pro Contour Brush and go in with Fawn to start the contouring. I like to just use one side of the brush so that way I don't apply too much product. So we're going to start right here in the hollows of her cheek. Blend it up. So that way we get a really soft look and we don't get a line. Again, I only add a little and work my way up with product. It's a lot easier to add than it is to take away. And then I'll take a step back as I blend to make sure that it's looking even. And go around the temples. Always take a step back. Perfect. The reason why we contour is to give some dimension to the face and accentuate features or change features. In this case, with Devin, we're just going to accentuate her beautiful features. Fawn is a perfect color for her skin tone. Creates a perfect shadow color. It's not too dark, still looks natural. I'm going to take just a little bit around the hairline so that way everything blends. This Sephora brush is perfect for contouring because of the tapered brush. I'm going to go with a little bit down the side of the nose. I'm going to pinch the brush a little so that way it doesn't put too much product all over the nose. I just want it right here in this place. Her nose is already quite slender, so we don't need a lot. I'm going to go back in with my Morphe M527. No product on it, just to make sure everything is blended. We're going to start with, so for highlighting, we're going to go in with the Sigma Tapered Highlighter Brush. It's also another tapered brush that I really like to use for highlighting because it'll help us to get into smaller edges or smaller corners of the face. It's just not as fluffy or as big as the Sephora brush. So we're going to take Banana and we're going to highlight under the eye. I'm going to press it and then blend it out. Banana is a great color to use on her skin tone as well to create a really natural highlight under the eye. Highlighting is going to bring out the high points of the face. I'm going to take a little on the chin. I want everything to look balanced, dimensional. Look up for me. Just do a little bit more right here. Perfect. So she is highlighted and contoured. Now we're going to take it up, bump it up a notch with the highlighting, and take sand on a Laura Mercier fan powder brush. Just going to put it in here. This is just going to accentuate the cheekbones. I'm also going to go on the Cupid's bow. And down the bridge of the nose. Adding highlight to the bridge of the nose already creates a slender effect. I'm going to go in with the Sigma brush again on its own. There we go. I'm going to go back in and bump up the highlight a notch with the Anastasia Glow Kit. I love this kit. Same Laura Mercier brush. And I'm going to take Sunburst and Dripping in Gold. Mix those together just to bump up the highlight. We want a glow. We're gonna do a warm eye look, so these colors will complement that perfectly. Yes. I just really feel like, you know, in these days you can never have too much highlight. All right. Let's add a little blush. When highlighting and contouring, always finish with the blush. We're going to go with NARS Orgasm, and then we're going to do the Morphe E4 brush. This is perfect for blush. It doesn't pick up too much product. The bristles are not super dense, so it's not going to apply a lot. Just a soft, blended amount. There we go. And the blush should go right in between the contour and the highlight. There we go, perfect. Oh, perfect. And you can always take a little down the nose too. Perfect. All right, so let's start our eye look. We are first going to give Devin's brow a little bit more shape to help define her eye. We're going to go in with the Anastasia Brow Wiz in Taupe. With the hair. So I'm going to start here and move her brow in just a little closer towards, there we go, right here, and then underneath. I'm going to make Devin's brow a little bit thicker to, in order to define the eye and fit the shape of her face a little bit better. And I'm just taking short brow-like strokes. So that way it looks as natural as possible. Perfect. And then I'm gonna take the tail. So from the tail, I'm gonna go up on top of the brow. I'm going a little bit above her natural brow again to make it a little thicker. Step back, check your progress, and then with each step in the that you do with the brow, I always comb through to make sure that it's going to look as natural as possible. And the taupe is a little bit lighter, so to create some more dimension with Devin's brow, I am going to take the Anastasia Dip Brow in Chocolate with the Sephora Pointed Brow Brush. This point is going to help me to create some more hair-like strokes with a darker color, it'll give the brow some dimension and help it to look as natural as possible.
So I'm just going to take light strokes. Don't want to go too heavy with this because Devin's light complexion and blonde hair, it would not look very natural.
Perfect, and I'm going to still use the, well, the right end of the brow is to comb it through. Okay, perfect. Other side. I'm just doing the same thing that I did on the other side. Always remember to step back and look at the progress too. Make sure that everything is even. I love this brush for the brow because it doesn't apply the product too heavy. The point is perfect. Darker. I know I said perfect, but it actually needs to be a little bit darker. Okay, now perfect. And then I'm going to go in with the Anastasia Pro Pencil in base 1 to clean up and define the brow. So it's just going to clean up underneath. This is such a perfect pencil to use. The point on it and the shape is a perfect cleanup. Right above. And then just take your finger to blend it into the skin. Same thing on the other side. Defined brow. All right, moving along to eyes. Like I said before, we're going to do a warmer look for her eyes. So I'm using the Modern Renaissance palette. You can create tons of different looks with this palette, but today we're going for a warmer look. So I'm going to take the burnt orange just a little bit using the brush that came with the palette. And we're going to take this burnt orange color and go into the crease. And just blend it through. Okay. And I'm just keeping this in the crease, and I'm going to keep blending until the product is evenly distributed through the crease. And then blend it into the lower brow portion right here. All right, I'm going to also take Golden Ochre and blend that right on top of it. I just like the way these two colors look together for her skin tone. Same thing on the other side. With these shadows, you only need a very little amount, super pigmented. And we're gonna keep, even though we're doing a warm look, we are gonna keep it more natural. So after the crease, we're just gonna deepen up the outer edges. I'm gonna take Antique Bronze, just deepen up the outer edge. Using the same brush. Open your eye for me, perfect. These colors look beautiful on her skin. Okay, let me blend it out a little bit more. Okay, let me see. Perfect. And I did get a little bit of fallout, so I'm just going to take a nice big fluffy brush like the one we used for bronzing earlier. And then I'm going to take Tempera to finish it off, mix with the Golden Ochre to create a nice soft lid color. Keeping the lighter colors on the inside, make sure that the eye is fresh looking, wide, and open. So when she opens, it gives a really nice bright appearance here in the center. Okay, look up for me. So everything that we did on the lid, I'm just gonna bring it down below so that way it's balanced. If we keep the colors only on the lid and don't bring them down to the lower lid, it could look heavy. So I'm just gonna take a little bit of that burnt orange and the Golden Ochre and then just kind of buff it out on this lower eyelid. And then I'm going to take Primavera, Vermeer, mix them together. I want you to just look down and then this direction for me. I need to highlight the inner corner. And then this direction. And then look up. Perfect. And then we're going to finish off with a little bit of Butterscotch lip gloss to complete the look. This is a perfect color for this look. Warm, but soft, and also natural at the same time. Actually, I'm going to go back real quick, finish up. I want to make the eye look a little intense on the outer corner with the Dark Side Anastasia eyeliner.
So I just want to take a little bit and deepen up this outer corner. And then smudge it in. You gotta work fast with this because it, oh, wrong brush. I'm gonna smudge it in with a concealer brush. Look up for me. I'm just keeping it on the outer corner. It's going to keep the eye open and give it that cat-like effect on the outer corner without actually doing a cat eye. Okay. Okay. And then we're all done. Thank you so much.